everyone. Good evening, respected jury members. I'm Dr. Anuja, and I'm talking about human identification using smile photographs, a review. Next slide, please. Next slide. Well, with increasing advancements in technology, there's a constant evolution in the methods of identification, especially with regard to forensic odontology. With the advent of selfies, it has made capturing smiles all the more effortless and accessible. The human dentition is a unique tri-dimensional apparatus because of variations in size, shape, and position of teeth, and therefore, the dental traits are considered as unique as fingerprints. Also, resistance of teeth to fire and decomposition renders them extremely useful for identification purposes. Next slide, please. The methodology of smile superimposition consists of comparison of antemortem and postmortem smile images showing dental traits, especially the upper incisors and canines. Protocol by D. Anglis suggests it is important that the postmortem images must be photographed from the same angle and position as the antemortem images in order to obtain an accurate identification. Next slide, please. The most commonly applied techniques in the interpretation of smile photographs for human identification include, the first one being direct comparison of morphological traits. Now, in this method, the antemortem photograph and postmortem photograph are placed beside each other, and they are observed for specific dental characteristic traits like the shape of the crown morphology, the position of the teeth, the dental arches, crowding of the teeth if present, absence or presence of missing teeth, and several other such dental criteria. Previous slide, please. Several other such dental criteria are assessed and a positive ID is made. The second method includes dental superimposition. Now, in this method, postmortem photographs are taken in a frontal view and they are cropped and dragged to superimpose over the antemortem photographs. And then finally, the opacity of the photographs is adjusted to 50%, thereby allowing visualization of both the antemortem and the postmortem layers simultaneously. And this helps to aid in identification. The third method includes analysis of incisal contours of anterior teeth. Now, in this method, the incisal edges of the upper teeth, that is from canine to canine, are traced in both the antemortem and the postmortem photographs. They are then entered into a photo app or Photoshop software and then superimposed in order to obtain a positive identification. So this method will help determine whether the antemortem and the postmortem photograph belong to the same individual or not. So these are the most commonly applied techniques. Next slide, please. Now, smile photography has its own limitations, the first one being low image quality of the antemortem photograph, followed by limited number of visible teeth in the antemortem photograph. Another important factor to take note is the possibility of morphological changes in the dentition since the antemortem images were taken. Now, all these factors could hamper the positive identification. Next slide, please. Now, some of the cases that were solved using smile photography include the first one on the left-hand side. Now, in these photographs, antemortem photographs of a missing individual were given and they were compared to postmortem photographs. Now, if you look at this photograph, the yellow arrow in the first photograph and the second photograph indicates that the incisal edge of the central incisor it has been chipped off. The blue arrow indicates the position of the lateral incisor in the first quadrant. The red arrow, the position of the lateral incisor in the second quadrant, and so on. In the images below, that is C and D, the red arrows indicate the presence of white spot lesions in both the antemortem as well as the postmortem photographs. So in this manner, that is by direct comparison, a positive identification can be obtained or was obtained in this case. In the second case, a young girl was missing and the only clue or the only evidence that the family could provide was that she had a buccal canine, a canine that was buccally placed. That is, it was placed anterior to the rest of her dentition. Now, this proved to be a turning point in cracking this particular case. And in the third case, that is the extreme right-hand side, the incisal contours were traced in both the antemortem and the postmortem photographs, and they were superimposed using Adobe Photoshop software, and hence a positive ID was obtained. Next slide, please. So when the anterior dentition is recovered with the skull and a smiling antemortem photograph is available, the shapes of the individual teeth and their relative positions are considered sufficiently distinctive for a positive identification. Miranda et al. In 2016 described a case in which selfie photographs were used to identify a carbonized body by using the smile line and image superimposition. Thus, the study proves that even a selfie can aid in identifying humans. Next slide, please. D. Anglis et al. In 2015 described a comparative method in which photographs are implemented into imaging manipulation software, making it feasible for the creation of distinct layers for both antemortem and postmortem data. Thus, simultaneous visualization of these data allows the superimposition of both for potential matching. Next slide, please. So in conclusion, several centers for forensic expertise cannot afford high-end devices, most importantly because of the expense, especially in emerging countries. Despite the advancements in forensic sciences, traditional techniques continue to be of great value, particularly in developing nations. Hence, the use of smile photographs is a valuable and low-cost technique for human identification. However, training and awareness are required in order to obtain accurate results. Next slide, please. So in future prospects, developing an automated digital dental identification system is a demanding challenge at present. It is important that all clinical practitioners maintain appropriate records of patients and use digitization wherever possible. Therefore, it's important to create awareness and also ensure that you smile while you still have your teeth. Next slide, please. These are my references. Thank you.